Hello, moms and dads, boys and girls. I heard that it's going to be very cold in Cape Town from this afternoon. So whatever weather is coming from Cape Town is coming to us. So we're going to get very cold on Thursday, that's tomorrow, and on Friday. So you must make sure that you dress nice and warmly, that you have blankets on, that you drink hot chocolate, and just stay nice and warm. All right, boys and girls? Right, now today I want to tell you the story of Jonah. Yes, now Jonah was running away, boys and girls. Do you know why? Let me tell you why. Because God asked him to go and tell people in Nineveh, it's a place, to stop being naughty and stop being bad stuff, or else he's going to destroy all of them, boys and girls. What does it mean to destroy something? It means to kill everything, to break everything down. So Jonah, he didn't want to listen to God, boys and girls. So he ran away. He tried to run away from God. And the devil was telling him a lot of lies. And he was listening to the devil, boys and girls. So Jonah, he went on a boat. See that boat? And the boat went the other way, the opposite side of Nineveh. So Jonah went down and he slept at the bottom. Inside the boat, there was a place where you could sleep. So he went there and he went to lie down and he fell asleep. So what happened? A big storm came, boys and girls. The sky turned dark and the waves were big. And the poor boat was going up and down on the ocean, on the sea. And people were getting so scared, it felt like they were going to die. So the one man, that he was the owner of the boat, he went downstairs to Jonah. And he woke him up. He said, "Wake up, wake up." He said, "Why did you come onto this boat?" Jonah said, "Because I'm running away from God. I didn't listen to God." He said, "Throw me over the ship. Then you will see that it will calm down. The sea will calm down. The storm will calm down." But the people felt too bad to throw him into the sea. So they really tried. They tried to row in this big ocean and with this big waves around them. They tried to row away, but it didn't want to calm down, boys and girls. So eventually they decided to throw Jonah in the sea. And you know what? God was very gracious. He sent a big fish. And you know what the fish did? It swallowed Jonah. Yes, it opened its mouth and it swallowed Jonah, boys and girls. And Jonah was inside that fish for 3 days. Count with me. 1, 2, 3 days, boys and girls. While Jonah was inside the fish, he started to pray. He said, "Dear Lord, please forgive me. I didn't listen to you. I didn't obey you, Lord Jesus. Please forgive me. Please, I will listen to you." And you know what happened? After the third day, God let the big fish take Jonah to the beach and he spat him out and Jonah was on the beach, boys and girls. And then what did he do then? Do you think he listened to God? Yes, boys and girls. He went to Nineveh. And he started walking around in that big city for 40 days. And he started shouting. He said, "Repent, turn to God. Come on, everybody, turn to God, or else he's going to destroy the city of yours. He's going to bring everything to break in the city. Come on, repent. Everybody, repent, because God is coming. He's on his way." Do you think the people listened? Yes, they listened, boys and girls. They repented. They said sorry to God. They said sorry for all the bad things they've done. And what do you think God did? Do you think he saved that place, boys and girls? Yes, he did. He did, boys and girls. He didn't destroy that place. So what does that mean? It means you must obey the Lord. You must listen to the Lord. If the Lord tells you in your heart, you know this little voice in your heart that says to you, "Listen to mommy, listen to daddy." You must listen to that voice because the Lord is speaking into your heart that you must listen to mommy and daddy. And sometimes when your brother or your sister is doing some naughty stuff, or they're pulling your hair and you feel like smacking them, yes, I know you do sometimes, but this little voice in your heart says, don't be ugly to your brother, don't be ugly to your sister, don't smack them. That's the Lord talking to you, boys and girls. So we must listen to the Lord. All right. Okay, boys and girls. Until next time, when I'll bring you another story. Bye.